नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक इज जीरो फोर्स मेंबर्स हियर. ओके, सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस जीरो फोर्स? सी, इन द स्ट्रेस सिस्टम आर द स्ट्रेस स्ट्रक्चर, सम ऑफ द मेंबर्स आर नॉट एट ऑल प्रोड्यूसिंग आर द सब्जेक्टेड टू द फोर्सेस. ओके, so there are two conditions, there are these two conditions, and whichever satisfy these two conditions, they are not subjected to any force. Okay, so these two conditions are very simple, and this is an important concept. Why? Because if you observe the previous year questions, okay, most of the questions are most of the stresses are given in a such a way that they are having the zero force members. Okay, so once if you know this, then simply look at the problem and then you can write the answer. Okay, that is that much simple. So here first condition, what is that? If only two members, this is important, first condition, only two members form a stress joint at some junction joint and no external load or support, there shouldn't be any external load or also support reaction is applied to that point. Okay, then the two members must be zero force members. What is the meaning of that? There is a joint at which there are only two members. Two members are forming a joint, and at that joint there is no external force and as well as the reaction force. Okay, in that case what happens? The two members which are forming that joint are not having any force. That is the meaning of that. Okay, so first we will see this example. See, for example, here we have this. Let me name this. Okay, this is the A, B, C. Always we are giving names to the joints, you need to remember. C, D, E, F. Okay, so here we applied the force at F, and there is a reactionary force at C and as well as A. And you identify the junctions which are having only two members. Okay, so junction B is having only two members, and as well as the junction E is having only two members. Understood? So here, at the rate, junction B, what are the members that we have here? The member is AB. Here we have AB and as well as the BC. Okay. And at the junction E, okay, we have FE and then ED. Okay, these are the members. And here the force produced in the AB is FAB, and the force produced in the BC is FBC. And the same way force in the FE, FEE, FE, and then here FED. So here we need to identify whether it is satisfying the first condition or not. What is the first condition? At B, only two members are joining and there is no external force or the reactionary force that is produced at the point B. Okay, so I can assume that FA and FB both are zero here. Here it is zero and this is also zero. And if I take the E point, there also, here it is a zero because it is satisfying the first condition. Is there any other junction? There is no other junction. At A there are three members, F also three members, A, B, C, this is the D. D also three members. Okay, so that is how we can now easily tell here. So here the equivalent frame will be converted like this. How? So it will be simply like this. Okay, this will be simply like this. I will draw the bigger one. I will draw here. Okay, I will draw here bigger one. This is simply becoming like this. What is that? From A to C, and then this is the one, this is the A. This is the A, this is the F, and then this is the C here. And from here, we have this one. And here we are applying the force F here. This is the A, C, F, and then D. Okay. Why? Because here I removed, this link and then I removed even these two links. Why? Because there is no force. When there is no force, then what is the use of that if they are not taking the force in the system? Okay, so that is the equivalent one. Understood. And here, what is the second point? The second point is, previously we have seen the two member system, two member joint, and here whenever you have the three member joint and three member form a stress joint for which two of the members are collinear. Okay, this is important. Collinear means, you know, they are on the same line. Okay, two are on the same line, then the third member is a zero free. Whichever is a not collinear but inclined to the first two, which are on the same line, then the force in that third one is zero, provided of course there is no external force or the support reaction applied to that joint. Understood. So previously two member, and here the joint is formed by the three members. So let's take this example here. Okay, let me name this one. So this is the A, B, C, D, and then E here. Okay, so here see, the joint E is formed by two members but there is a force applied, so I cannot apply the first point. And then B and A are anyway fixed, and the remaining is D and C. And at the D, what is happening? You know, this ED and DC are parallel, and again at the C, what is happening? DC and CB are collinear, not parallel, sorry. So if that is the case, then what is happening? FAD equal to zero. See, for example, if you take this juncture, let me draw here, I erase this, and then for example here, if I take the joint D here, this is the D. Okay, so this is a, let's assume this is the FED, and then let's assume this is the FDC. Okay, and then this is how it is going. Let's assume it is a compressive or whatever it is. So this is the FAD. So here FAD is becoming zero. Understood. Why? Because this need not be 90 degrees to this, any angle. Okay, and again, if I take the point C here, point C means junction C here, this is the C, and this is the FCD, and then this is the FCB, and then this is a, you know, let's assume, you know, whether it is a compressive or tension, we don't no need to worry. So how it is going? This is going like this now. So this is the FAC is how much here? It is becoming zero. Why? Because these two are collinear, and whichever is the third one is joining at the collinear point, you know, that is a free force member. Okay, so here I can remove these two, right? If I remove these two, then the equivalent structure is nothing but this. This will become like this. This is the equivalent structure. So here, this is the junction or the joint E, and this is the A, and this is the B, and of course this is the point D, and this is the point C or the joint C. Okay, so instead of using these links, I will remove and I will keep like this. Okay, there is no difference between these two. So find the zero force members from the below examples here. So what is the first condition and the second condition? First condition is related to the two member joint, and then the second condition is related to the three member joint, and there is no external force and then reactionary forces, and in case of the second point, at least two of the three members should become the collinear. So here first come to the first one. the force is applied at the junction B and at C and A are, you know, reactionary forces. So you remove this C and then A, and here also force is applied, you remove this also. So here, what is the remaining one? The remaining one is here, and you can apply the second condition. What is that? Here, DA and DC are parallel, those two lines, and then DB is perpendicular to that. So your doubt is whether DB is having the force or not. Here in this case, since the applied force is horizontal, then the force FDB will become zero here. Why? Because, you know, it is a parallelly applied. Otherwise, instead of that, if it is applying, you know, vertically like this, in that case, whether the DB is becoming zero or not, it depends on how much force AB and BC are taking. Since it is a triangle, they take that, okay. Otherwise, sometimes, you know, they may not take. So carefully you need to solve this if other end of that same link is subjected to the forces. Okay, it changes from case to case. Here in this case it became zero, and then we'll go horizontally and come back. And here this is the second problem. In this problem, okay, I am removing the B and as well as the C, because these are reactionary forces are there, and at the A we applied the external forces. And what are the remaining joints? The remaining joint is only D, and at the remaining joint D, what is happening? Okay, there, you know, both are collinear, and this is making an angle. So the force in this FDB equal to zero. Understood? And here naming should be done. Here I will do naming A, B, C, D, E. A, B, C, D, yeah, that is a. So here first I will remove the, see, this is the reactionary joint, and this is also reactionary joint, and this is the external force applied joint. So I removed these three, and what are the remaining joints? The remaining joints are the remaining joints are, you know, what are the remaining joints? So this is the C and this is the D. And here what is happening in the, at the C, see, at the point C, what is happening? It is the condition one here. Okay, what is the condition one? This is having the two member joint, and there is no external force or no reactionary force. So automatically what happened here? FCD equal to zero, and as well as the FBC also becoming zero here. Okay, so FCD and BC are becoming zero. I will remove these two. I will remove, I will cut, you know, from here like this. Okay, I cut this, so this is looking like this. And again, if you look at the point D, it is looking like a, you know, two point joint. So again, can I apply the same thing, like a, since, you know, there is no external force or the reactionary force, can I take like a, here the forces are zero in the ED and as well as the DB? We cannot take. Why? Because here if I cut this, what is happening? This is what is happening, this is being compressed to, this is subjected to the compression, right? So see the compression. So this is acting like this. What is this? This is the FDB, and here also it is a FDB. But here at this junction, if I take the junction B, what is happening? FDB is nothing but the 100 Newton. Okay, that means here I cannot take the FDB equal to zero. Understood? So you know, if you want to take the, to find out the zero force member, the other junction to which it is connected, that is also important. That is what I am trying to say here. Okay. And coming to this, So first I will remove this junction and this, and as well as this junction. And what are the other junctions that we have? The other junctions we have is this D junction. Okay. So at the D, there is no external force or nothing is there. So what is happening here? So that means here force in the DB equal to zero. When there is no force in the DB, then I can simply remove this. Okay, I removed this. When I removed, then what is happening? If I take the junction B, what is happening? Again, you know, we can apply the second principle. What is that? These AB and BC are collinear, and this is making an angle. So whether it will become zero or not, we need to find out whether FBE equal to zero or not. Okay, E to B, it is connecting E to B. Okay, so how will you find out this? By, see, this will become zero when how many forces are there at this junction? There are five forces, you know, at this junction. Okay, if those five forces are balanced without this FEB, then we can say that this is also becoming zero. Okay, generally it will become zero. Okay, why? Because you know this is a horizontal. See, actually what is happening, this is a vertical force, so that the AE will take the vertical force, and the horizontal force is 100 newton, and this inclined force FED, this is the FED will take care about this force. Okay, so that even if you don't have this link, then there is no problem. So that we can assume FBE also zero here in this case. Okay, so finally this is how it look like. And then coming to this, okay, so here first I will remove this junction, this junction, and then this junction. Okay, what are the forces applied junction, and then the reactionary forces, and what are the possible junctions that we have? The possible junctions that we have is here, this one. Okay, straight away what happened, FD is becoming zero here. Why? Because these two are collinear, and this is a, you know, making some angle. So I will remove this at this junction. I remove like this. When I remove like this, because there is no force, so that's why I remove that link. And again, if I take the junction D, these two are collinear, and then this is a simply, you know, going like this. Okay, so I can assume that FDG also becoming zero. Why? Because there are other joints that will take care about the applied force here. Understood? So here I removed this also. And again, if you come to the C, what happened? Otherwise you come to the B here. See what happened here. Since, you know, at the F there is no force, so FD become zero. FD become zero. But whereas if you take the joint H, there is an external force acting at the joint H, and HB will not become zero. So here FHB, that means this is the one, is not equal to zero. When this is not equal to zero, so I cannot remove this, so that you know this is also cannot be removed. Okay, so this is what, this is a FBG is not equal to zero here. FBG also not equal to zero. This is also not equal to zero here. Okay, I cannot remove these two. But whereas here in this case I removed these two. And now we need to find out the situation at this C. Okay, so here what is this? C to G, right? So FCG, the force in this is FCG. Whether it is becoming zero or not, see, if it is becoming zero, then what happened? How many links are there here at the junction G? You know, FGF is there, FGH is there, and FGB is there. So all these three forces will take care about you know this 5 kilonewton. So I can remove this also here. Understood? Okay, in some of the cases what happened, I may not be able to remove that in some of the cases. Okay, what are those such cases? Here we have seen, See, here I cannot remove this thinking that it is 0. Why? Because here if I make this as the 0, then what is happening? Here equilibrium condition is not satisfied. But whereas here still the equilibrium condition is satisfied even after removing this. So I can assume that the force in this CG is 0, but whereas I cannot assume the force in the DB is 0 here. Why? Because if I remove that link, then here the equilibrium condition is not satisfied, but whereas here at this junction G, the equilibrium condition is satisfied. That is the key. What is that? Sometimes you will get some of the confusing junctions or the junctions with some ambiguity. Okay. So at those junctions, how will you decide whether you know the particular member is the zero free or not? By taking the you know the corresponding other joint, if it is satisfying the equilibrium condition by removing this link, then in that case you can assume that the force in that particular link is zero or the member is zero. Otherwise you cannot assume that. Why? Because it should satisfy the equilibrium condition at the other junction also. Okay, we will see some more cases, but in the examination they may not give this much difficult one. If you can understand this, then it is more than enough. Okay, in examination they will give very very straightforward questions.